Of our Lord, 1897. Jonathan Harker takes his first brave steps on his long and perilous journey. His single purpose is to rid mortal man of this appalling creature and banish his memory from the realms of the living. For while he lives, terror roams the earth. But beware the stones across the bog, for they conceal a hidden danger.
Thank you.
And so Harker, oblivious to the cruel and terrible dangers that await him there, boards the coach that is to speed him into the very heart of the Dark One's domain. But take heed, for lifeless statues are not always made of stone, and the Count, in one of his many guises, may drain your mortal body.
Thank you.
Success is but a pinprick of light in a land of darkness. Dracula flees the onslaught, and in an attempt to pursue, Harker enters the dungeons. Cold, dank air freezes his lungs as he prepares to face the evils that await. A word of warning. The brides are abroad, seeking to feed on the blood of a living man.
Thank you.
Dracula, in one of his most potent and fearsome guises, is banished from his own kingdom. Harker now turns his attentions back to England, where his loved ones face the wrath of Dracula, the wolf. He returns to Hillingham House, the London home of his fiancée, Mina, and her longtime friend Lucy, who is even now succumbing to the charm of the rejuvenated barbarian count.
Thank you.
Lucy now walks in the realm of the undead, her young body racked with the desires of the evil one. Harker's own living hell is plagued with horrific nightmares, which only the light of day may overcome. But his attentions are now drawn by the need to lay Lucy to rest, and to defeat the hordes of mental patients who have escaped from the nearby asylum and are in league with Dracula.
So you still pursue me, foolhardy mortal. So you still pursue.
Thank you.
The young Dracula, now banished from English soil and suffering utter defeat, flees to his homeland. Harker must follow. His will to see the monster slain, driving him on into Transylvania and to the very door of the beast itself. He takes with him his beloved Mina, who is possessed by the spirit of the vampire. Her only cure is in the death of Dracul. Your steed awaits. You must ride like the northern wind in pursuit of your deadly foe, who at this moment slumbers in his coffin. The story is almost complete, but as the end draws closer, Harker must now enter the very sanctum of the Dark One. Only Dracula's beautiful bride stands between Harker and the final death of Dracula. He enters the courtyard with foreboding in his heart.